Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Justin Stokes Outdoors. Before we get into today's video, I wanted to remind you about my 1500 subscriber giveaway. I'm giving away two $50 Bass Pro Shops gift cards to two of my subscribers. In order to win those, you need to go ahead and follow me on Instagram. Go find my Instagram page. There's a link in the description, or you can go to Instagram and look up Justin Stokes Outdoors. Follow me on there, subscribe to the YouTube channel, and in a couple days when we hit 1500 subscribers, I'm gonna tell you guys some instructions on how to enter to win those gift cards, so be sure you're paying attention for that. I appreciate each and every one of you guys that support this channel and watch the videos. Without further ado, let's jump into today's video. All right, so if you're watching this video, you've at least probably heard something about this Mike Long guy. Being exposed as a fraud. He was recently exposed in this YouTube video showing him snagging or foul hooking these large bass out in California. And what he was basically doing was taking a drop shot with a treble hook on it and throwing it over the backs of these spawning bass and foul hooking them and reeling them into the boat. And this guy, if you don't know kind of the history, I put a link to the video in the description, so you guys go check that out for sure and watch this video. But this guy is like the big bass guru out in California. He's like the guy that knows how to catch them and all this stuff, a big swim bait pioneer, or everyone thought he was anyways until this video came out. But after watching the video, I saw it when it came out a couple days ago. After watching the video, it was like at the first part of the video, I wasn't even convinced that he was actually snagging these fish. But as I watched the video, I was like, yeah, he's definitely snagging them. But I didn't really, you know, it's kind of like, I'm sure the guy was a big swim bait fisherman, caught a lot of big fish, because the guy claims to have caught a couple hundred fish over 10 pounds, like 75 bass over 15 pounds, just all these huge bass. He's got several lake records, been in all kinds of magazines, on TV shows, all kinds of stuff, just like this real big guy out west. And I actually heard about the guy the first time. He was mentioned several times in this book, talking about the quest for the next world record bass. And that's, I read that book several years ago, and actually first time I heard about Mike Long. But never really followed the guy, never really paid much attention to it, just kind of knew who he was until this whole exposure thing happened and him snagging, cheating, stealing, lying, all that stuff in these tournaments and whatever. And just some of the things that happened. There's also an article. So after the video, I watched the video and it was like, man, he probably has caught a lot of big fish, but you know, he got caught snagging them. Well, then I found out recently that there was an article going from the very beginning, from back in the 1990s, all the way to present day, of all the just like absurd things that happened that were questionable about his career, tournaments he fished, lake records he had. I mean, for example, he had a lake record on two lakes that no one ever saw the fish. He showed him a picture of a large fish and said what it weighed, and they were like, okay, took his word for it and gave him the lake record. And that really is what kind of struck me as odd, how that even happened. Because if you don't know, if you don't follow my channel or my Instagram, you probably don't know, but earlier this year I caught a bass that weighed 1220, and on the lake I caught it, the lake record was 1256. So when I caught it, I knew it was really close to the lake record, and I wanted to have it weighed and all that stuff. And just in order to be eligible for the lake record, it had to be weighed on a certified scale. There had to be witnesses there, pictures, measurements. The Parks and Wildlife came out, you know, to look at the fish and all this stuff. And it was just like, it's a process to even have a chance at taking over the lake record. And I obviously didn't do it. The fish didn't weigh quite enough. But for somebody to just take some pictures of a fish and say, hey, I caught this bass, it weighed 18 pounds, and them to just give them the world record just blows my mind. But I guess the guy, I mean, he was a well-known guy around there, and I guess they just took his word for it or whatever. It wasn't surprising. But, you know, when someone claims to have caught a couple hundred bass over 10 pounds, that's already just got to be kind of alarming right there. And then 75 over 15 pounds, that's, I mean, the majority of America fishes their whole life and doesn't catch one over 10 pounds, much less a couple hundred. I mean, it's just, it's absurd to even think about it now that the guy's been exposed. But for so many years, everyone had their speculations about it, but there was no real evidence of it until this video and article came out. So I left the link for the article in the description. Definitely go check it out, because it really just plays out exactly how this guy cheated and stole his whole way through his career. The next thing is just kind of the moral side of this whole thing. It's sad to see in your life, whether you're famous, you're not famous, you think you're a nobody, whatever. You have people that look up to you, whether it's a sibling, family member, coworker, whatever. You don't have to have a YouTube channel. You don't have to be popular on Instagram. You don't have to have a TV show. You don't have to be an athlete to have people that look up to you. And in life, when these people look up to you and admire you, as an example, you've got two choices. You can either be a good example, one that's, you know, the people can be proud of, or you can be one that's a terrible example, like this Mike Long guy was. And no doubt there are people that probably idolized this guy as, you know, the swim bait king and the big bass king and all this stuff that this guy was named. He was on billboards and magazines and all that, like I mentioned. And the guy just, his whole life is a waste. It turns out he's a fraud and a phony. And, you know, just what a waste of potential that this guy could have had for, you know, helping people out, being a good encouragement to them, and just wasted all of that. In Galatians, Paul's talking to the church in Galatia, and he says, am I seeking the approval of man, or am I seeking the approval of God? And he goes on to say, if I'm seeking the approval of man, then I'm not being a servant of Christ. And that's a perfect example of what happened in this situation. This Mike Long guy got so caught up in the fame and the money and the likes on Instagram, and everybody, you know, just, oh, Mike Long, he's the king, he's the, you know, big bass specialist, all this stuff. He got so caught up in the approval of man that he just kept, his lies got bigger and bigger, and his cheating got worse and worse, until it all comes to a head, and then he's exposed as a phony. And it's just, it's so sad to see that it seems like it's happening more and more. There's just a story of a guy that was trimming the tail on Lake Fork, because it's a slot lake, and he was trying to make his fish shorter so that he could win the tournament, and he was busted. And it just, your sin is always gonna find you out. When you cheat and you steal and you lie, you're always gonna get busted. And here's this guy that for years has been building this legacy, and then to find out he's just a fraud, cheating, stealing, and lying. And I looked on his Instagram, or tried to find his Instagram, and it's been deleted, and most of the companies that sponsored him along the way have removed his pictures and all this kind of stuff. And it's just so sad to see that this guy, you know, just wasted all of the potential that he had to bring glory to God, but instead he wanted to bring glory to himself, and now he doesn't even have the glory for himself, and now everyone's just irate at the guy and getting all this negative attention. And, you know, I don't know what's going to happen to the guy. I don't know if he's going to go to jail because it's illegal to snag these fish. I don't know if I'm sure there's going to be lawsuits against him for all the money that he's won fraudulently. I don't know what's going to happen, or if the guy's just going to be banned from tournaments. I don't know why he would even try to fish any tournaments at this point. But I don't know what's going to happen to the guy. I'm sure no one really does at this point, as the story's just unfolding. But in your life, you have that opportunity. Are you going to bring glory to yourself, or are you going to bring glory to God? And every time when you choose to bring glory to yourself, it's not going to work out. It's not going to fulfill you. I promise you, even at the heyday, Mike Long had to go home and live with the fact that he was lying to thousands, millions of people. He knew that he was a fraud and a phony all along. He didn't have true joy and true happiness in all these pictures of these big fish. Yeah, in the time he might have had a rush seeing all the likes and the, you know, the popularity that he had, but I promise you it was eating him up inside all along. So there's a couple lessons to be learned from this story. One is that seeking fame is not, it's not the way to live your life. It doesn't matter if you have a huge YouTube following. It doesn't matter if you're popular on Instagram, if you get one like on your pictures or you get 100,000 likes. None of that stuff matters. What it boils down to is, are you bringing glory to God or are you trying to seek the approval of the world? And if you're seeking the approval of the world, it's going to leave you unsatisfied every time. You're going to end up doing things that are immoral, that are, you know, you normally wouldn't do just to get those likes, to seek the approval, and it's just going to wreck your life like this guy's life has been. Another thing to learn from this is that your sin is always going to find you out. It doesn't matter how sneaky you think you are, how good you think you are at lying, whether it's in fishing or it's in your marriage or your finances or whatever it is at your work, school, sports, whatever. It's always going to find you out. You may get away with it for years and years like this guy did, but it's always going to come back to bite you. So just remember, it doesn't matter about the fame. It doesn't matter about the money. Live your life for Christ, bring glory to Him and not yourself, and you're going to be successful, whether, and that doesn't mean money and fame and all that stuff or health or any of that, but at the end of life, you're going to be successful because you can stand before the Lord and give an account for what you've done with your talents and your gifts that He's given you and that you brought glory to Him other than glory to yourself. Thanks guys for watching this video. Please hit the subscribe button, like the video, and leave a comment about what you guys think should happen to this guy, if he should go to jail in your opinion, if he should just be banned, if, you know, everyone should just let him be as he is. You guys let me know in the comments what you think. Thanks for watching the video, and I'll see you guys next time.